Hi, my name's Caleb, and today we'll be learning the basics of Elasticsearch. We'll deploy our own Elasticsearch cluster, learn the basic terminology and structure of Elasticsearch, index some data, and even do our very own first search. So let's get right into it. First things first, what is Elasticsearch? Elasticsearch is a super powerful search engine. Honestly, it doesn't sound very exciting until you realize how it can be used. At its core, you feed Elasticsearch lots and lots of data. And then when you ask for specific types of data back, Elasticsearch is able to return those results very quickly. When you think about it that way, there are lots of different use cases for it, ranging from a generic search engine, or being used in big data for data visualization and analysis, or it could be used as a logging solution. I mean, heck, in the real world, it's even used as a solution for video games. So literally, the only limitation is your imagination. While Elasticsearch is not real-time all across the board, it can return search results in near real-time. Elasticsearch far outperforms standard database queries and generally leads to a more pleasant user experience, if optimized and tuned correctly. If you want to know more about tuning or performance optimizations in general, be sure to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel as we'll be getting more into those topics in the near future. Or if you really can't wait, post a comment down below or check in with our consulting team. We've helped some of the largest businesses in existence set up both Elasticsearch and Solr. Link for that down in the description below. Anyways, back to Elasticsearch. How does it search millions, if not billions, of datasets at such fast speeds? Well, to understand that, we need to know what an index is. An index, sometimes called a shard, is a type of document that lists the location of all the data related to a specific subject. Think of it like this. Let's say you have a textbook about biology. Within this textbook, you want to see everywhere the word duck is mentioned. Traditionally, you would go through the whole document and find a few results, page X and page Y. Great. Now your teacher wants you to find all the references to the word penguin. Does it make sense to keep searching through the whole book front to back each and every time a search request is made? No, there has to be a better way. So instead of doing that, let's go through the whole book one time and create an index that lists the location of each object, saying ducks are on page 23 and 24, owls are on page 3, 4, and 7, and penguins are on page 7 and 12, etc., etc. This way, when you search, you can just look at the index and return relevant results much quicker. That is what Elasticsearch does, but on a much larger scale. It receives a document, it creates an index, and can return these results very quickly to the user. Now, that's about as far as our example will take us. With books, creating and maintaining an index is easy because the book doesn't change every second. Databases, on the other hand, change very quickly. So how does Elasticsearch keep up with all this new data? Well, it does a lot of things, but for our understanding of Elasticsearch, we need to know that Elasticsearch runs one big indexing process on startup and then only updates new data as it comes in. This makes the initial startup process take more time than normal and is something we will want to avoid in the future, as updating indices is one of the most expensive things to do in Elasticsearch. And as indices get larger and larger, the amount of time it takes for your Elasticsearch instance to index its data will get larger and larger. This is by far the largest problem most developers have with Elasticsearch. You start your own instance of Elasticsearch, everything is fine and dandy, but over time, your index gets too large, a queue is formed, errors start getting thrown, customers are having frustrating experiences, and your client loses business. We don't want that. So how do we avoid this problem? Well, another beautiful thing that Elasticsearch does is break that large index, or shard — a shard is an index — into smaller and more manageable pieces, called shard segments. This gives Elasticsearch the option to assign segments of those shards onto other nodes. These other nodes can then help in the process of searching when a search request is made. This increases speed and performance. Again, this is a very important concept. A shard, the index, can be broken into smaller pieces of the indices called shard segments. Each node will only have to search that segment instead of searching the whole index. Think of that book example again, but let's say that the index for this book is huge, so you brought a friend. You and your friend are looking for a specific word in the index. Instead of having both of you search the whole index from front to back, just rip that index in half. Half for you and half for your friend. Share the load. Dreamwork makes a teamwork. But the same concept here in Elasticsearch. We make multiple instances of Elasticsearch, break the shard down into pieces, and place each piece on the node. This process is known as sharding, and I think whoever named that needs a raise. As more and more shards are placed on a system, you will need more and more nodes, aka more instances of Elasticsearch. This allows you to scale horizontally, distributing the workload across multiple systems and not just scaling vertically, like adding memory or CPUs to one existing system. But as we add more nodes into our system, we get new problems. As you build out your cluster with more and more Elasticsearch nodes, you will need to monitor all of these nodes. And for that, I highly recommend getting a monitoring tool. You can try and set up your own if you like, or you could try out our tool, Symmetex Infrastructure, for free. Link for that down in the description below. Collect hundreds of Elasticsearch metrics, like the number of Elasticsearch nodes and shard status, the number of indexed documents, size on disk, indexing rate, node-to-node transfer stats, pretty much everything you need right out of the box. Also, get smart alerting and notifications for when something goes wrong. But honestly, the best part about the Symmetex tool is that you just set it and forget it. We already have presets and alerts specifically designed to monitor and optimize your Elasticsearch cluster. But whichever tool you decide to go with, please, please, please just get one. You will thank me later. I think that's enough theory for now, so let's just jump right into it. So the first thing you are going to need is to install Elasticsearch. You can install Elasticsearch in many different ways, either on bare metal, virtual machine, containerized, or even via Kubernetes. But for now, I highly recommend just using Docker containers. It's just so much easier, it has all the dependencies you need in one place, and that's what we're going to be doing in this video. If you need help putting Elasticsearch on Docker, we have a whole video dedicated to installing it. So go check that out and come back here when you're done. One thing to notice, if you follow along and use Docker, make sure you have the volumes set up for your data, like so. Once that's set up, we can just do docker compose up, and this might take a few minutes if you haven't pulled the image already, and then go into the browser and access the port where Elasticsearch is installed. And here you go. Easy peasy, squeeze a lemon. Now, let's do two things. Let's give Elasticsearch some data to index and run a search. Before feeding it data, it's important to know how to interact with Elasticsearch and what kind of data we can feed it. Elasticsearch API can be interacted with via HTTP requests, so pretty much anything that uses HTTP will work. While some people prefer to use the curl command in terminal, I personally prefer using the built-in IDE / developer tool, but it's good to know that both of these exist and you can do whatever you like. Let's create an index with the API. First, use the put command to make the index. Since I'm going to be using dummy data about videos, let's call this index video search. I could just create a shard by saying put video search and call it a day. But let's make three shards and add a replica. We can tell Elasticsearch how many replicas to make in the settings. Put video search and settings, and then number of shards, we'll set that to 3, and then number of replicas, 1. Now we have our indices. Let's get some dummy data. I left a link below to some dummy data that you can mess around with called Berlin buzzwords, with video info, like what you would find from a streaming platform. And as you can see, I have lots and lots of JSON files filled with dummy data. Now we need to get this data into Elasticsearch. There are a few ways we can do this. We can do it via the Kibana dashboard, but I'll teach you a useful trick for sample data of this size and with this type of formatting. So let's use a simple bash command. Go into terminal, cd into the directory where your files are, and type this out. For files in JSON, do echo n file curl expost h content type application JSON localhost 9200 video search doc d cat file, echo, done. This right here runs a loop that finds all of your JSON files in the current directory. And if it finds one, it does a curl request posting it in Elasticsearch. Note that if you are not using the same data as me, you can change the video search area with whatever name you chose for your index. Sweet, and everything went well. So ES now has our data and has made an index for us. One quick comment on indices and shards before we continue. Shards are actual instances of Apache Lucene, a search engine library that does all the heavy lifting, hosted on the node. Both Elasticsearch, Solr, and even OpenSearch are all built upon Apache Lucene. Lucene is the actual motor or brain in these systems, and it does all the indexing. So it's useful to know the limitations of Lucene if you really want to master any of these systems. We won't go too deep into detail on that here, but I'll just point you in the right direction. More reading on this topic down below. Now, back to Elasticsearch. Let's see what shards we have running on our cluster. Let's run get cat shards video search, or whatever the name of your index is, and ?V. Here you can see how many shards we have, how many replicas exist, and where it all is. We can see everything, and we see that it is working as it should. Now let's run our very first query. Let's search for titles that match the word Symmatext. Run a post request video search, search, query, match, title, and ? Symmatext. And here on the right side, we see our results. Metadata is up at the top, search results are on the bottom. And we can see exactly how many search results we got, we can see how long it took, and all that other good stuff. Congratulations! You just started your very own Elasticsearch cluster, created an index, uploaded data, and ran your very first search. Mess around with this a bit more as you need to get familiar with Elasticsearch. There are a lot more subjects to cover, and we plan to make videos similar to this one in the future, so stay tuned for more. Let me know if you have any questions down in the comments below, and let me know if there are any other subjects you would like to dive into deeper. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Keep monitoring, everybody.